Dear friends, today we are going to discuss the interference of light. The general meaning of interference is, we can say, the disturbance. So, to see the interference of light waves, it is necessary that light waves must be coherent, their amplitude must be same, and they should be monochromatic. So, if two waves of same frequency, same amplitude, and monochromatic, moving in the same direction, and if they are meeting at a point in the medium, then due to superposition principle we can have a resultant wave. This resultant wave has amplitude maximum on some points and minimum on the other points, or the intensity minimum on some points and maximum on other points. It is known as interference. This interference we can observe only if light waves must be coherent, monochromatic, and of same amplitude, and if they are moving in same on they are moving in same direction. And if the light waves are polarized, then plane of polarization must be same. To this interference, we can have points of maximum intensity and minimum intensity. The points where maximum intensity observed is known as constructive interference, and points where minimum intensity is observed is known as destructive interference. If the path difference is equal to 0 lambda, 2 lambda, 3 lambda or n lambda, then we have constructive interference. And if the path difference is lambda by 2, 3 lambda by 2, 5 lambda by 2 or 7 lambda by 2 or n plus half lambda by 2, then we have destructive interference. In case of destructive interference, the intensity is 0. And in case of constructive interference, the max intensity is maximum, and generally it is 4I0. That if the amplitude of the waves is A and A, then it will be resultant amplitude will be 2A and the intensity will be 4A square, or we can say 4I0. Interference can be studied by two ways. One is division of wavefront and other is division of amplitude. Mostly experiments which are based on division of wavefront are the Fresnel biprism experiment and most commonly the Young's double slit experiment. And the experiments which are based on division of amplitude are the Newton's ring experiment and Michelson interferometer experiment. In Newton's ring experiment and Michelson interferometer experiment, which are based on division of amplitude, always there is a requirement of broad source of light. That directly this light which is coming from source we can use for the experiments. And in case of interference which are based on division of wavefront, the light source must be small. One more, or we can say the light source must be fine. In Fresnel biprism experiment, always we will use a slit. While in the experiment of Michelson interferometer or Newton's ring, the light which is coming directly from source we can have. One more interesting example of division of amplitude is the colors in thin films or interference in thin films. The thin film must be of micrometer order, otherwise we cannot observe. In interference due to thin films is that if a light ray is coming directly from source P and if it is incident on a film which is, we can say, RSTU, then this part of this is reflected from A and we get a AE ray, and some part will be refracted and it reaches at B inside film. Again from B there is a reflection and refraction also. So the reflection from B reaches at C and we get a CF ray, and similarly from refraction we have BI ray, and similarly this way a continuous reflection and refraction takes place and we can get the rays AE, CF, BI and GH. These rays, we can see the interference between these rays. So AE and CF will be known as reflected rays, and BI and GH is known as transmitted rays. and we can observe the interference between the reflected rays and transmitted rays. By mathematics, we can say that these rays are the interference between reflected rays and transmitted rays is complementary to each other, and also the films appears as colorful. If we observe the soap bubble in the sunlight, then it appears colorful. This is due to the division of amplitude interference, and the interference is due to amplitude division of amplitude, and interference is due to thin films. Similarly, in a water tub, if we put at one drop of kerosene oil, then it also appears as colorful. This is also the example of division of amplitude and interference due to thin films. The most common experiment for division of amplitude is Michelson interferometer and Newton's ring experiment. In Michelson interferometer, we can have the two mirrors of 100% reflectivity, so that we can get the light rays reflected back from the mirrors, and one plate which is semi-polished that gives us the reflected and refracted ray, or we can say the amplitude is divided. The importance of interference we can have at various places. The most important is the anti-reflection coating, where we can have the mirror or the glass as anti-reflecting. By putting a coating on that, we can have anti-reflection coating, and we can also have the interference filters, and by these interference filters we can have the desired frequency or desired light here from the filters, like in chemistry the filter papers.